One is the random rate, we don't know the delay time, like it's 1 second, 2 second, how many seconds we don't know. Second way, we can use the kind of functionality of the controller, we can calculate the 1 second delay and we can add that to it. Okay, but that will be again complex. We have to generate the interrupt for timer by using 1 second. We have to calculate the clock frequency, we have to divide by the particular frequency and all of that. We have to do the calculation, we have to find the value of the resistance to use the 1 second delay. That is what again complex task. Okay, you guys have to do that. Okay, you can see here data sheet. Open the data sheet and check timer. Completely one software is available in the data sheet, which will give you the information how many generate the delay by 1 second. Okay, if you use that, then we just have to call the functions, it will automatically give the 2 seconds delay. Okay, so that was second way. Okay, third way is that if you want to do it by using, I'll show you, I have that example as well. So these are the 11 experiments that we have to do now. Okay, on the BTU interface. Okay, 11.
Thank you, sir.
11 interfaces. Once we finish that, we'll come back. So this is also again one more blinky, but this is third way to do it. Okay, how we have done that? Go to the options for target, you can see now which voice we have selected. This is voice across. Okay. So in this we don't have to write delay function. We can just call OS delay function is there because this is not this is with OS. We can call the OS delay function and we can do it. Okay. This is third way. Now second way you have to implement by using timer interrupt, you have to generate the interrupt and then you have to generate the 1-2 second delay and then you can do this. So this is the third way. Okay. I will not go into this detail. Okay. Guys, but listen to me. This kind of example you can develop in final year project. Okay. That will be will be impactful because this is not just C code, this is having so many concepts inside that. Okay. You might have studied in big subject, but these are the important concepts that you can use. Okay, all the important concepts. Okay, moving to next task now. Got it? Any doubts before moving? Any doubts? Okay, second way I will show you that without using software packs. Okay, that will be the fourth way of doing LED blink. I'll show that. I have that as well. Can you see now? So this is the fourth way, which is not having any senses. You can see in the left side. Did we add any startup, this senses pack or anything like that? Nothing. This is completely pure C. Okay, like without any help of senses pack. We have done the same, not so difficult in that. Okay, we'll just compile this and we'll see. Now you can see this is not only one LED, this is all 8 LEDs. Can you see the same code, but not only one LED, this is with all the LEDs available. Okay, this is with fourth way. Now you can decide which way you want to do it. Okay, like easy way. Okay, I feel that the first method you have seen, that will be easy. So that you don't have to worry about the data sheet, go to the data sheet and find out which flag you should select, use all these details. If this way you want to do it, now you can have the data sheet of each and every register what it is doing and all that information you have to understand, and then you have to use it. Okay, but best by using developer code, by using software packs, so that you can get all the information, middleware packs and all. Done. Now coming to, now suppose if you want to see the full fledged menu of the on this board, so how to see that? Click on pack installer. Okay, you have internet connectivity there. I don't have, but I don't need because I have installed the pack. Okay, done. Type here LPC 1768. Click on the examples. Before that, you should see, when you select this, you should see it is installed. Device family pack is installed. If it is not installed, click on install. For me, it is installed. It is asking me to update. Okay, done. All of you on this page. So see, this pack installer will make developers life easy, so that it will give all the examples which we can develop on this board. Okay. Download it. No, see, keep on just install. It's up to date. It's installed. Okay. Just check for you. Click on the LPC. Okay, it's installed. For you, install. Click on examples there. Click on example. If we have done this activity last time, please tell me. Okay, I will not repeat this. Okay. Can you see that demo LCD 1768? Copy the example. Select the where you want to copy the example. Just click on OK. Demo example is there. Okay. Done. Select the debugger. Settings. Okay. Build. Okay. And click on download. Done. Done. Okay. Now you can see full-fledged demo of this board, what all things it can do. Demo, you can see ADC value. As you move the knob of this potentiometer, the color of this ADC value will change. Now it is not changing because we have to connect this jumper here. Okay, and now you see it's moving. Yes. Okay, not only that, buttons also, user buttons they have given. Okay, as soon as you press the button, joystick also you can see. Okay, just download and see that too fast. It's updating. No need to update. Just copy the example. Are you able to click on copy? No, then wait for the that completion. Okay, before that, 1 minute, I'll just explain you. Can you see that how many examples we can use? Morning, we have explained how many ports available and how many functionality we can do. So, we can copy any of the example and we can develop your final project also. Okay? You don't have to, you know, go to the low level details. Just copy one of the example and think of an idea and implement that idea into this example. Okay? If you want any explanation on this one of these examples, any of these examples, just let me know. We will do that as well. Select the same folder that we have morning we have done. Okay. Simulation, how we will do that. Okay, open the any Blinky that we have done. Okay, I'm checking this demo one. Okay, so how to select software debugging here? Now go to debug. Instead of use Jlink, we have to select use simulator. Okay, first before this, have you downloaded and checked the output? No? Okay, you finish and then. Okay, I'll just explain you. Okay, use simulator here. Okay, and just start doing debugging here. Okay, when we use simulator, if you disconnect both the debug port pin and its hardware pins also, then also it's fine because we have used the simulator. You don't have to connect any. Click on debug. I have disconnected. You can see port size is shown. Okay. Has come to main. Now, so LED on. So which is on? You can see in the board, LEDs are connected to port 1 and port 2. So fifth LED is on port 2. So if you want to see the view, peripherals, ports, port 2, okay, and click on the run button. Can you see the LED fifth number blinking here? Can you see? Okay. So if you don't have the software debugger also, we can do software simulation and we can see the each GPIO information as well. Yes, ma'am? Any doubt? Yes? No? Okay. Got it? Step by step debugging. I'll stop this and I'll show you. Okay. So suppose, look, see, can you just guys how you can first Okay, this is without using debugger. Now I will show you without debugger you have to do Kaizen Jelly. Okay, you have to add the breakpoint, you have to add all the traditional breakpoint and that you have to do. How do you do that? Suppose if you want to add the breakpoint, just click on here. Done. Okay, I'll just click on here. So control will come to my here. Okay, now this is step by step debugger. So this is step one line, it will come to next line. Step out means complete function, it will come out of while run. Okay, it will come out of that function, LED1. Because LED1 is one more function, if you go to the definition of it, it is one function inside that. Okay, come back to the back button. Yeah, okay, so delay is again function, step over and step out. Step out means it will completely execute this function, it will come out. And this is a reset button is also there. Can you see that? It will come to main if you do that. So it has come to main. Okay. Again you will go to the breakpoint. How will you go? You just click on here and we will go. And if you want to continuously execution, we can see it. And you can do the left to the right. Then you can see the continuously. Okay. Yes. Which one? Which see how to get this port interface? Go to peripherals. Go to GPIO fast and click on port. Okay. Done. And then just click on run button. See, I have told you how many options, 5-6 options. So you can do any. What happened? It's not blinking. Go to main. Main what's it? Go to the other. what our food is. Anyone else in show is similar to blinking? Nobody has got, is it? What about you? Blinking is not happening, it's similar to yes? It's working here?
So the delay is working.
Yes. What is saying? Okay, wait. I'll just check. But in front of you only there. This is 12 megahertz only. Let's check. Clock. How much is the clock? Just stop the debugging and check the clock. Okay, you guys tell me now, like, how you want to go ahead. You want to start with your fitness or you will do some exercise on the board itself? You want to do some hands on and then see. Guys, the basic understanding of C is what? Okay, when we come to this lab, especially mechanical hands, okay? Study C language in while one you probably when function calls and all, we should know. Okay? It's not that difficult, you can just go to Google and just start studying a question like that. It's not that difficult. I understand this mechanical point of view, but it's not that much strong. There must be that, but you don't need that much also.
There is a simulator also, online simulator. See,
online
you can type the code and
yes.
They have that code also. You can run
one website, I will tell you, you can just go to that website. It's a tutorial point, okay? You can just online compile it there. You can just write code and you can see the output. No doubt we install any software also. Okay? Then we'll go to the video interface now. Okay? See how many examples we can do on this board. So this we will start now. First one is scalar input, not one. What is this? I'll explain the code first. Okay, you guys have the same code in CD. Okay, you might get that CD in some time. So can anyone tell me by using which method it is done? By using legacy device database or by using software file? This is done by using which method?
No software.
No software. So this is by using device database, legacy device database. Okay. Now you can do it by using software file as well. How we can do that? You know that. Go to the software that pack installer, and if you want to add that, that has to be shown. That method. It is open here only. Okay, go back. No, it is launch it. Can you see that now? Okay, SPD out. Okay. SPD out is nothing but display output on any serial port. Okay, for that we can use SPD out. So the way we have added for LED, similarly we can select the SPD out and then we can do that. Okay. But we will do the conventional method so that you can understand the code or how it works. Okay. If we go by this method, you want to understand how it works. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, morning we have seen that why do we need this? Why we have to develop serial communication so that we can do debugging and we can see the debug information. Sir, do we have a DB9 connector cables?
DB9.
DB9, serial cables. RSPI control cables. Coming to make function, see suppose now when we type anything on the keyboard, keypad of desktop, it will show on the teratom. Teratom is a common software which display the serial input messages. Okay, you can